Hi friends, let's make a snowflake icon in Figma. With winter coming to an end, I figure now is the best time to make a snowflake icon, so let's begin. I'm going to come over here to my 24 pixel icon grid, press the P key to pull up the pencil, click up here to draw a point. I'm going to hold down the shift key all the way down here to the center and click that point again. Notice that our line is still connected here. I can hit the escape key. Now I'm going to hover over that line once again and look for that center point. I can click on that center point. Hold down the shift key and draw another line. You'll see that it's still sticking. I can press the escape key, draw another point here from left to right at that angle, and hit the escape key. Now select these three points in our vector network up at the top and pull up the advanced stroke panel. Here I'm going to choose an endpoint of round, so we have our little tree branch here. Next, double click out of that, select our little snowflake branch, come up here and create it as a component. So this is a component. We're going to duplicate that to get an instance. So I'm going to hit Command D, Control D if you're on Windows. Then I'm going to press Shift H to flip it horizontally and Shift V to flip it vertically. And here we go. We have our next point in the branch. We're going to duplicate this a few more times. I'm going to copy both of those. Command C or Control C if you're on Windows, Command V, Control V if you're on Windows, and paste that right on top of itself. We're going to hold down the shift key as we rotate them both. So 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Let's copy. Let's paste that one more time. Hold down the shift key as you rotate it. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. We now have our snowflake. The cool thing about having this within the component is we can go to the main component and it will affect all of these pieces evenly. So if you wanted to make any adjustments, if you wanted to move this up, you wanted to adjust where these points land, you can easily do so just in that first main component and it will follow in all of the instances. So let's make our last few adjustments there. I'm also going to adjust the stroke size. Let's make our stroke size 1.5, so it's just a little bit thicker. Next, what I am going to do is make two versions of the snowflake here. So let's duplicate that. I'm holding down the option key. It's going to be the alt key on Windows as you drag. This first one up here, what we're going to do, we're going to select them all and then press Command E. And what that's going to do is flatten them all together as one single vector object. So it's no longer representing that main component in all of the instances. We can now go into our next one. So if this is a stroke, we're going to make our fill version. I'm going to select all of those branches. Once again, all of these are instances currently. We're going to come up here with our Boolean groups option. We're going to choose union selection. This is going to join them all together as fills. So now when I press Command E or Control E if you're on Windows, you can see when we double click in that they're all individual points. For the last little bit of detail, I'm going to select these six points here in the middle, and with them selected, I'm going to come up to this vector panel up here and choose a corner radius of 0.5, and that's going to give us this nice little detail and a larger center of mass. So when we zoom out, we can see better definition of our snowflake. So hopefully you found that helpful, and as always, happy designing.